one question is, have you read the ISIS papers by Dr. Francis Kress Welsing?
Mr. Fuller?
No, I haven't.
Okay.
And a lot of people find that surprising. But Dr. Welsing and I used to travel a lot together, and she would make her presentation from her book, and I would just listen because I like to hear what she had to say. I mean, directly. And that stands alone. And I tell people even today that I have not read her work because I didn't want her work to sort of like influence how I would think on different positions and whatnot, because she said when I first started talking to her many years ago, back in the early 1960s, and the late 1960s, I started talking to her about my ideas and whatnot, and she says, well, your ideas are very, very valid, I think, and all like that. And, you know, I understand you're working on a book, and so you should put them in that book, and I'll help you to do that, which she did. And she said, but you are talking about what to do about the situation. I said, yes. I said, because I've been hearing all kinds of things about what the problem is, but I haven't heard about what an individual person can do. And I want to write a book on what an individual person can do each and every day, what he or she should be doing and not doing, I mean, to solve this problem. Because I think that ultimately it will come down to individual actions, individual people scattered all over the world, and eventually all of them getting on the same page about a code for what to do and what not to do. And she says, yes, you're talking about what to do about the problem. So I am going to go to the root of the problem, and that's what she told me, and find out why white people act the way that they do toward people of color. There's got to be a reason, and I'm going to get to the root cause of that reason. And I said, well, I'll have to continue to work on what to do about it, and you work on the why it came about anyway in the first place. And so when we start traveling together sometimes on many occasions, I mean, she would present her views crystal clear from her point of view about the why, and I would present my views as best I could, sometimes not so clear, but as best I could about what to do about it. And that's what I'm still wrestling with.
Yes, sir.
But in answer to the question, no, I've never read the ISIS papers. I have copies. She gave me a signed copy of it. I have that. And but I've never read it because I want her ideas to stay pure. And when I talk, I don't want to inadvertently contaminate something that she said. That's why I tell people, get Dr. Welsing's recordings. She's not here anymore. But get her recordings and read her works and keep them separate.
Yes, sir.
She herself said that she was going to write a preface for my book, but at the last minute she changed her mind. And she said, no, you keep what you're doing pure on its own, and I will write what I write, and I will keep that pure on its own. Mm-hmm. And that's what I recommend that everybody do.
Mm-hmm.
That you don't mix up what somebody else is saying with what you're saying. That causes what?
Confusion.